Hi guys, and welcome back to the Citadel. Now, what you just saw in these intro clips, I just wanted to show you some stuff I built off camera. You saw that little rooftop club already a couple of times, but I just wanted to show you that from close up a little bit, because I didn't record the building process of it, but at least you got a close up now from that. But what I actually wanted to show you is that I replaced all the Caesar networks on this whole map, which was also the reason why it took me so long to put out a new episode. I really wanted to get rid of these Caesar networks for reasons I'm gonna talk about in another episode. But for this episode, we're gonna focus on the suspended monorail hub. And as you can see, we are already on it. So here I just copy and pasted this whole area to the outskirts of the city, so I can build totally freely and not being interrupted by all the stuff that is around that place. So when I was building this suspended monorail hub, no network tracks existed, so I had to use these normal stations and kind of hide them under this plateau where I wanted to build it. And maybe you saw me before using the move it mod while pressing the alt button on the keyboard to select the nodes from the station tracks in these station assets. And I was just checking how much I can raise them up in the air so the citizens could actually use the monorail. And as it seems, you can raise up these tracks as high as you want, and as long as you place a pedestrian path to it, the citizens can still use the station pretty normal. But it made this whole project way more complicated than it needed to be, because I had to hide the station asset in the park, in the sunken parking, and build all these pedestrian paths way, way high up in the air. First, I was just figuring out the general direction I wanted these monorail tracks to go to. And my thought was that I wanted to have two monorails going into the same direction and on the same level as well. And I wanted to have a third one on top of them, which was rotated 45 degrees, so it makes an interesting shape. The next step was to place these paths from the Park Life DLC on top of these monorail assets, so the pedestrians would actually stay on this path rather than the actual platform. And then I just connected these very narrow pedestrian path to it and connected all the necessary nodes to one another. And finally, I raised all these networks to the correct height and just tweaking all of these nodes into the perfect position, so pedestrians have enough space to go under these tracks to change the platforms and to have the connections for the ground level pedestrian path. And after every step, I just copy and pasted this whole structure to the outsides to have a safe somehow. And here you just see me placing this 45 degree station on top of the other two, finding the correct height, checking from every direction, and make a safe again. Then I thought the time has already come to put this whole structure to the actual place where it belongs. And as you can see, the stations are now hidden in this parking structure underneath it, while the station tracks and all the pedestrian paths are just floating pretty high up in the air. I also exported this whole structure with the move it mod in case I mess something up. And then I started already connecting or creating some kind of lines, even though I have no idea where all of these lines will go in the future. I just wanted to have this base infrastructure where I can work off from. Would you have a look at that? It already worked almost perfectly from the start off, except from these few vehicle assets that went skydiving there. But I managed to fix that with tweaking these nodes a little bit more. And now we're moving already on to the detailing part, which was really insane because there was so much stuff I needed to hide with POs and props and frankly mostly POs. I started off with these concrete platforms, turned them into PO, and the reason why I didn't went for the normal ploppable pavement or something like that is that you can see through them from underneath it. And I definitely wanted to have some shots where you kind of look up to this suspended monorail hub from the street level below. And yeah, I needed to have something that doesn't disappear when you look from that angle. So I just plopped these concrete slabs everywhere on all of these platforms, and I had to tweak them so the vehicle doesn't bump into them. And obviously to hide the pedestrian path as well, even though I'm gonna switch it to an invisible one in the future. But for now, I really needed to see where this path actually go to connect them and all that stuff, and that's why I didn't switch it already to an invisible path. Since it's really time consuming to build an open view staircase or elevator thingy, I decided to go for this, I don't really know what exactly it is, but it seems like an elevator enclosure somehow. And yeah, I found this asset and I thought it's just perfect to hide the pedestrian access to the actual platforms in it. Obviously turned them into PO to fit the width and all of that stuff. Placed them at every corner of these platforms because I wanted to have access for the people at every single corner of it and not just one massive entrance. And then I had this idea to create these pedestrian bridges that are enlightened by night, and I just thought it would really look really cool if you could actually see the pedestrians going to there corresponding platform. And yeah, I just thought it would look really alive if you could actually see them. And so I designed this whole structure so you could see all of the citizens walking around and waiting for the train and stuff. And I guess one inspiration for that was Fluxtrends when he was building his Avalon city. He said he wanted to create this massive public transport hub with citizens walking all around the place using staircases and sky bridges and that stuff. And I thought, since he never finished this project, I wanted to do something similar. Granted, it doesn't look that impressive, but I already know that I'm gonna build an even crazier public transport hub in the future with city walk, city walls, hyperloop asset, and just a lot more different means of transport, so stay tuned for that. And while we're at it, if you like this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps this channel out, and yeah, I would just appreciate it very much. I was actually pleasantly surprised to see this morning that I finally got my first Patreon. I don't know if I'm allowed to say his name out loud, so I will just skip that part, but thank you so much for your support, I really appreciate it. And if you would like to support me with what I do, consider to donate just $1 or something like that a month. I mean, it's not much, but it just shows your appreciation as well. And something that would also really help out is if you would join my Discord server and share your ideas for this project and what your general thoughts are about it. This would really help me out because I just find myself often struggling with my own imagination somehow. I'm not exactly sure how to build this city, even though I just got a little breakthrough a couple of days ago, how to expand the city in an efficient but also very cool looking way. But especially when it comes to just expanding the city and finding the right buildings and assets and all that stuff, I really struggle because I've never built a city that big like this one. And I think it's especially tricky to find these kind of filler blocks or filler buildings. I never have the perfect height somehow, and Maybe I should start live streaming. What do you guys think? So we could help each other out a little bit. You get a bit more content, and I get your ideas and your help on that one. But let's move back to what we are actually building here. So my idea for this hub was in general to create a very messy and not too sturdy looking building, or rather a structure with a lot of crazy commercial underneath it, which is inspired by Tokyo again. And on top of these commercial buildings, I wanted to have this structure looking very improvisational. So I used a lot of gantries and stuff. And since it would be a big risk for people to fall down in between these station tracks, I just used this green fence thingy. I think it's from a Japanese asset pack somehow. Turned it into PO, flipped it 90 degrees, and just squeezed it in between these station tracks, so people couldn't fall down. On the very top of this whole structure, I placed a lot of advertisements that are enlightened by night, which looks really cool. I also put some glass roofs over these stations. And at this point, I realized that this whole structure is gonna be way more PO heavy than I expected, and also gonna take way more time. I started to use the labeling tool from the Move It mod. No, it's actually from the Find It mod, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it's the Find It mod. To kind of make these groups of all the assets, I named all of these metal thingies gantry, so I can just type this in and find all that corresponding stuff. So I found these cross beams, which I thought would fit perfectly to the side of this hub. And I thought it fits really well to that messy character of this whole structure. So I placed this crossbeam asset all over again and again. This approach worked actually pretty well and efficient, except from the end of these station platforms, where I had to extend the concrete slabs a little bit more and yeah, just fit all of these parts together somehow. Then I added some more buildings underneath it, squeezed them together, and just tried to make them fit somehow. And it started to get really complicated because I was blocking my own view all the time with other buildings and networks. But I just love these kind of challenges. For builds like this, it's always a little bit tricky to find some kind of an exclusion, if that's the right word for it. And I decided to go for this Japanese train station entrance asset. I think it's something like that. And it just fits perfectly in that space to place them all around the station. Then I added some more pedestrian bridges to the other side of this main street there. And this is definitely something for a future episode, to develop the area on the opposite of this street here. I did some research and I discovered that Tokyo has actually, I think it's 3 or 4 different downtown types. I'm not 100% sure, but I think there's definitely the financial district, the cultural district, and maybe something like the industrial and even a fourth one, if I'm not mistaken. And I'm really eager to also develop different downtown types and spread out all the crazy skyscrapers and just create a very vast and big city. Continued unwrapping these staircase towers with these Baybridge gantry assets. I think they are the actual pillars from the bridge or something like that. Then I finally switched all the pedestrian paths to the invisible ones, which was a really satisfying moment for me to see all of these disgusting vanilla props disappearing. And then I added some of these mandatory or almost mandatory pipe assets everywhere to really add to that messy look, and even put some of them on top of everything. And later on, I'm not really sure if I'm gonna show this, but I added some steam spawners. Not totally sure about the looks of it. I let you decide as usual. And now it just saw me placing down some of these animated sign assets. They're really cool because when you transform them to POs, you can type on them whatever you want. And I just went for something fictional, like there's a delay on a certain line or something like that. Now you can see that the color settings changed a bit. Reason for that being that I'm constantly trying to figure out what kind of light and color setting is suited best for this series. And it varies actually a lot. Sometimes I'm more into a very monotone and dark looking setting, but then I think it would be nice if you see a little bit more details and stuff like that. So I'm still not totally sure what kind of setting I should go for. Maybe I should make a poll in the future with my different settings, and you can decide over on Twitter or something like that. I'm surrounding this whole plateau with these concrete fences for security reasons. Place down some more props, like these awesome benches from Sven Berlin. Some trash cans here and there. And for the cinematics, I wanted to have this transport hub surrounded by a lot of buildings, so it looks like the city is already complete somehow. But yeah, so I just placed down some random taller buildings, squeezed them together in the usual fashion, always with the idea in mind that the suspended monorail should sneak its way around these skyscrapers and in between buildings and even through buildings, through tunnels and stuff like that. And this is exactly what I meant in the first episode. I'm constantly changing the arrangement of the taller buildings around the place, and if you see big changes, it's not like you're gonna miss something special, because I will redo it anyway. And now on screen, it's actually shown the technique I was talking about in the latest episode of Verville. I was talking about that I always build these kind of mini builds, so I can just copy paste them and use them all over in the city, because it's way more time efficient than building everything from scratch all the time. So here I'm trying to create some kind of a timetable for the suspended monorail tracks, together with some benches and yeah, this digital timetable hologram. But guys, this has already been it for today's episode of The Citadel. I really hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to like and subscribe as usual. It would be absolutely awesome if we managed to reach 1,000 subscribers until the end of the year. That would be really amazing for me. Head over to Instagram, follow me there for more insights into my cities. And I'm really looking forward to see you next time in the Citadel.
Electronics and radar of the empire.